So I heard something shocking. An Orthodox Christian said that icons were not part of the early church, nor was the liturgy. This is shocking that an Orthodox Christian doesn't know this. There were other issues which I'll address in another video, but this is from Dura Europus. Around 135, AD 135, this comes from. And it was destroyed in the early 300s, buried with sand. There's also a synagogue from around this period, actually earlier, with iconography on it. Paul references icons. And there are plenty of other early church fathers prior to Nicaea that reference icons. Epiphanius is irritated at the use of icons and actually talks about it. Says, oh, there's this this face of Christ in church that everybody's referencing, and he doesn't like it. Eusebius references from the 3rd century, from the middle 200s, references church father complaining about this statue of Christ with outstretched hands outside of a church, and gets irritated about that. So we can even see from those who oppose iconography in the early church that it was used. And also Paul in Galatians, his earliest letter, he says, "You with your own eyes have seen Christ depicted or portrayed, or however you want it, as crucified. With your own eyes." This is not reading. People say, oh, well, it can mean to read, but the way it's used, it clearly does not speak about that, you know? Second of all, the liturgy. Well, it's in Acts that they came together on the first day of the week, breaking bread, singing hymns, and preaching the gospel. And the liturgy is spoken about through every century. Hippolytus is the first one to write it down in detail. But you can see this in the Didache. You can see it going, Ignatius, you can see it through the whole thing. There were certain church fathers that didn't mention it because that's not what they were writing about. Irenaeus, why would he mention it? Right? But, yeah, these two things absolutely do. So it's quite shocking. All right, peace to you.